Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Inshallah, in this video, I'm going to be discussing about a recent comment or a joke that was made on stage by a particular comedian and the Islamic response to that, inshallah, with a few points in relation to laughter in Islam and the boundaries. Stay tuned, inshallah, to the end. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Nahmaduhu nasalli ala Rasulihil Kareem, amma ba'd. My dear respected brothers and elders and my honourable mothers and sisters, as Muslims we are aware, and not just Muslims, non-Muslims, of the tragedy which happened at Christchurch, and where unfortunately 51 innocent victims were slayed, and unfortunately they were just gunned down by this one absolute lunatic who decided to go in there with semi-automatic guns and just, na'uzubillah, make an absolute massacre of those innocent individuals that were going about their normal business, just come to the house of Allah to pray. So we make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give those families sabr and peace, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them also a ajr and a thawab and a reward for their patience, inshallah. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Now, the thing which I want to talk about is that as a Muslim or as Muslims, irrespective of who the atrocity takes part or takes, who it happens to, whether it be as Muslims, non-Muslims, take for example the Rohingya incident, the plight of the Uyghurs, the Holocaust for example, anywhere where anyone innocent has died, Muslims are against such a thing. It's not like we're upset because it was a Muslim. Muslims even spoke out about even incidents which have occurred, unfortunately, by individuals carrying out those actions in the name of Islam. We've spoken out against this, we disagree with this, and we condemn such things. And there is no space for this within the deen in any way, shape or form. But nevertheless, having mentioned that, and as a kind of thing, just as an introduction, what I want to mention is that as Muslims, we've been advised, we've been told, we've been instructed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam how to live our life in relation to joking, laughing, the boundaries of such. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned Surah Al-Hujarat, يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا يسخر قوم من قوم عسى يكونوا خيرا منهم إلى آخر الآية. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in chapter 49 verse 11, O you who believe, let not a group scoff another group, it may be that the latter are better than the former. And let not one group of women mock another group of women. It's possible that the latter are better than the former. So the verse carries on, but I want to just mention from this that as Muslims, we take this as evidence that we shouldn't mock other people, we shouldn't joke about other people, we shouldn't ridicule other people, and this is something which is, in essence, part of our faith. Now, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the bottom of our hearts, alhamdulillah, and we thank and make shukr that He gave us this deen and gave us this faith, because so many things have been covered, nothing has been left to chance. It's not a religion, it's a way of life, and so many things have been covered, and we are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alhamdulillah ala dhalik. Now, I'll give the guy the benefit of the doubt as well. I mean, he did come out and say, look, I'm not a racist, I don't dislike Muslims and so on. I'll give him, and if he watches this, I'll give you the benefit of the doubt. Because when the Christchurch incident didn't happen, fair enough, he did come out and he made a video and he was really, and he had his wisdom tooth taken out, so I'm assuming he had pain, and he thought it was necessary to reach out and say how he thought that was wrong. So kudos to the guy, he did do the right thing at that particular time. Now, as a person, who is he, what is he, how is he, that's not the discussion. I don't know him as a person. If I had the opportunity to sit down, I would have a chat, maybe I could get to know the person more better then. But I'm looking at it from a purely Islamic point of view, that why is this not correct? Why is it Muslims are offended? And then it will give a bigger picture to anybody that thinks, well, why are Muslims so offended? Why is it that they're jumping out and going all raggo and going all wild for? You know, it's only a joke. The thing is that for Muslims as us, we're very, very sensitive when it comes to certain areas of jokes. And the reason why is because our faith instructs us to be sensitive in regards to these topics. You know, if you haven't seen the clip, basically the clip, what he mentions is as follows. He says, he was talking about the Christchurch incident, and he said, do you know what was more sad than the 52 people being killed? Was the fact that at that night there were no taxis available from the people coming home from the nightclubs and so on. Now, obviously, that's, subhanAllah, that is, I mean, when I heard that, I really cringed. I was like, that's really, really, to me, that's really a low blow. You know, but the thing is that, again, with insaf and with justice, I mean, like I said, if you want more of an academic response, see our brother Muhammad Hijab, inshallah. But, you know, in all fairness, he's not just targeted. He's not a comedian that just ridicules Islam, for example. He talks about anything and everything. I mean, the guy came under scrutiny because he'd mentioned some issue about feminism and the Holocaust and so on. So I don't believe that he's targeted Muslim because he hates Muslims. I'll give him the benefit of the doubt. But then do we still have a right to be offended? Well, of course. I mean, that's why I choose not to watch such things. I choose not to watch the comedians like him and the others as well, which I don't want to mention their names. And we unfortunately know a few. And the type of jokes which some of these individuals come up with are highly offensive. And I think it's grossly wrong that we should have this type of thing in society. Now, this genre of dark humor, black comedy, whatever you want to refer to it as, which this gentleman, Isaac Butterfield, is involved in, it's a type of comedy wherein very, very sensitive, very, very, you can say, taboo subjects are mentioned, and they are sometimes ridiculed. There's no stone left unturned. Anything can be said, and it's said purely for jokes. For me, I class that as distasteful. I look at that as a lack of creativity, just mocking things, just to make. I mean, what has the world come to that we have to mock people for fun? Subhanallah. I mean, I just don't. As a Muslim, it just doesn't register in my head. You get me? But what I feel from my point of view, being obviously someone who's an imam in the community, someone who, alhamdulillah, has devoted many years to the Islamic sciences, I wanted to talk about from an Islamic point of view. Why are Muslims offended behind such jokes? Why is it that we can't have a laugh and think of it and just have a laugh, have a chill? I mean, it's only a bit of humor. But unfortunately, we don't regard certain things as humor. There are permissible aspects of humor and there are impermissible aspects of humor. Even if this incident was false, let's just say it was make-believe, it didn't happen. Even then, we're not allowed to mock such a thing because we're not allowed to even lie even when we joke. Jokes have to be of a true nature. It's got maybe a funny incident, an anecdote or something of the likes, but we're not allowed to just make up jokes, fabrications to make other people laugh. In relation to the use of the tongue, I'll just mention this much. Why is it that we emphasize the use of the tongue? Why is it that the use of the tongue is important for us? It's because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentions in the hadith, Imam Tirmidhi rahimahullah mentions hadith number 2314 and classified or it's been authenticated as sahih. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Indeed, a man may utter a statement. He doesn't see any harm within that statement, but yet for which he will fall into the hellfire 70 autumns. 70 autumns within the fire. And again, just throwaway statements, throwaway jokes, comments. And unfortunately, as a result, that because it affected people, harmed people emotionally, upset people, as a result, this person will suffer in the Akhirah. That's why Muslims don't joke like this. This is why we get offended. And this is why we, in the name of free speech, we don't look at free speech in this particular way. We have our boundaries. We have our limits. We wouldn't class it as permissible to ridicule other people of other people's faith, of other nations, other colours, and the likes. But nevertheless, unfortunately, this genre does exist and it is extremely popular. I mean, Allah knows the mentality of such people that they have to get a kick out of, I mean, listening to people being ridiculed. I don't know where the creativity has gone, subhanAllah. But then going back to the thing of, well, what if you make up just a fabrication? Unfortunately, no. This hasn't got no space in the deen. Imam Abu Dawood, rahimahullah, mentions in his sunan, hadith number 4990, the hadith has been classified or authenticated as being hasan. And there is a similar narration as well in Imam Tirmidhi as well, 2315, also hasan. So authentic hadith, where the Prophet ﷺ said, he said this thing, woe, yani curse unto that individual who tells things, speaking falsely to make people laugh. Very serious words, yani curse, woe to him who tells things, speaking falsely to people to make people laugh. And he mentioned woe to him. He mentioned yani this a couple of times at the end as well. So for us, it's a no-go. We don't make up lies, we don't joke, we don't make fabrications just to catch some jokers, they say, just for a bit of fun. Oh, it's just a bit of fun. No, there are boundaries. Laughing is permissible. We'll come to that, inshallah. And Balki, right, while we're in the subject, we'll mention it right now. Islam is not some morbid, gloomy, dark, kind of non-humor, straight face type of religion. Absolutely not. There's a time, a place, a manner in how we're supposed to joke. So if someone came to Sufyan ibn Uyayna, rahimahullah, and said, joking is not right. It should be absolutely outlawed. Absolutely, I beg your pardon. It should be absolutely denounced. Sufyan ibn Uyayna, rahimahullah, his response to that was, rather, joking, or rather, I beg your pardon, rather, laughing is a sunnah. but it's only for those who know how to do it and when to do it. Yani, it has its space, it has its place, it has its time, and it has its limits. And inshallah, that's what we're going to discuss, inshallah, going on further. Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, he mentioned that, or someone asked him, did the companions joke, did the Sahaba joke? Because the question may arise, well, you know, Islam, if it's that rigid, are we supposed to? Nah, Sahaba joked. Sahaba had laughs as well, but there were limits. He mentioned, this is Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, in response to that person who asked the question that did the Sahaba joke, he said yes. And the faith in their hearts was like mountains. Yani, just because they had faith, it doesn't stop them from having a laugh. These are human emotions. Nothing wrong with that. But let me give you some examples of the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. First one is Imam Tirmidhi, he mentions this in hadith number 1990, hadith is Hassan. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu mentions that some people said, they said, O Messenger of Allah, do you joke with us? He said, yeah, indeed, I do not say except that which is true. Yani, in his jokes, there's elements of truth. So he also joked with the Sahaba, again, but the things which he said were true. And a couple of hadith later, Imam Tirmidhi in the same chapter, in the 1992, he mentions another hadith again, Hassan. Both this and the previous one are both authentic hadith. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu mentioned the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Ya dhal adhunain, O the possessor of two ears. And Abu Usama rahimahullah, he mentioned, yani, in commenting that this was his way of making a joke. Yani, he would, as muhabba, as love, he would say things, you can say they were funny, but yet they weren't offensive, they weren't untrue, they weren't ridiculing, they weren't mocking. In the Shama'il Muhammadiyah, hadith 237, there's also an authentic narration there as well. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, he relates that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that a person requested the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam that he be given a conveyance. He wanted a conveyance. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said that the baby of a camel shall be given to you. A baby of a camel shall be given to you. So the person said, oh Prophet of Allah, what am I going to do with the baby of a camel? Yani, I want it for a conveyance. I want it to ride on. The Prophet ﷺ said, every camel is a baby of a camel. Every camel is a baby of a camel. Yani, this was his way of laughing and joking with the Sahaba. Element of truth. I'm still the child of my mother, despite me now in my 30s. And my mother is the child of her mother, and so on. So there's not that's not an incorrect statement. But nevertheless, yes, it's permissible to laugh, but there are some spiritual harms to laughter when it becomes excessive. And this is what the Prophet ﷺ told us to refrain from. In Al-Adab Al-Mufrad, the hadith can be found 253, and it's sahih. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu mentioned that the Prophet ﷺ said, do not laugh a lot. Do not laugh a lot. Why? Because much laughter kills the heart. Much laughter kills the heart. Now, the same advice was given by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to Abu Dhar al-Ghifari radiallahu anhu. Targhib wa Tarhib 2868, and his class is Sahih al-Ghairi. Again, authentic hadith. Where he gave Abu Dhar al-Ghifari seven bits of advice. One of those bits of advice was abstain. Abstain from what? Excessive laughter. Now, a question may arise. Hold on. I read in Bukhari, in hadith number 3294, the Umar radiallahu anhu mentioned the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَضْحَكَ اللَّهُ سِنَّكَ, and you can translate that as, may Allah keep you laughing. So what's the answer to that particular hadith? Ulama, shurrah, scholars of hadith have mentioned this. The understanding or the wording of this hadith, yani, what it means is أَدَامَ اللَّهُ فَرْحَكَ. أَدَامَ اللَّهُ فَرْحَكَ, yani, old Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, may Allah continue your joy and may Allah keep you perpetually happy. May Allah continue your joy and keep you perpetually happy. That's the more understanding of this particular hadith. Not that it's okay just to laugh all the time and be just a non-stop joker, crack vibe with the people. No, there's limits. Too much laughter, excessive laughter, as mentioned, is harmful for the heart. And what is classed as excessive, as I just mentioned before. Now, also remember one thing as well. There's no harm with laughter, subhanAllah. Let me make this point a second time. There's nothing wrong with laughing, but it shouldn't just be done all the time and loosely. And there are some limits. And as I mentioned, I've already said three. So for example, the joke should not be where you're saying something false and you're saying something which is an intentional lie, a fabrication. Number two, the joke should not be excessive. Number three, it shouldn't be to degrade people, to mock people, to ridicule people. I mean, once I had to grip up two students, subhanAllah, in the madrasa, Allahu Akbar, they're having mum cusses, na'uzubillah. Like, check out, your mum is so fat like this and your mum's fat like this. Bro, what are you getting out of that? What, such a thing is absolutely impermissible within the deen. No space for such a thing in our deen. But there are some additional points I want to cover, and these are also important when keeping in mind joking. Number one, or rather if you want to look at in terms of number, I've mentioned three or four things before. This is a carry on from that. It should not ridicule any aspect of Islam. If you look at Surah Tawbah, chapter 9, verse 65 and 66, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the munafiqeen in the negative light because they were mocking the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What were they doing was, they were saying that, are we only talking about it idly and joking, you know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, responds to that. And he said that, was it Allah and his ayat and his messenger that you were mocking? You know, and the ayat meaning what? Like, for example, verses, evidences, proofs, signs, revelations, things which are shi'ar on the basis of deen. And ulama also mentioned as well, if somebody ridicules the sunnah, ridicules it, this person also has issues with their iman. This person, that will take a person out of Islam. Now, it's not for us to go around and labeling people, but I remember seeing one video and it was, for me, it was upsetting because one Muslim brother, he thought he'd make fun by seeing next man with beard and calling them Talibans. Now, that's not even a joke. That's not even a joke. I can't see how that's funny. I really can't see how that's funny. And then he was talking about, you know, women in niqab. He was using them portraying them in his videos in a negative light. For me, that's distasteful. That's not even funny. I don't see how that's a joke. You get me? Just making people laugh for the sake of laughing. Nah, man, there's got to be limits as well, even for a Muslim. And that's what I'm saying. This is, yeah, I mentioned about the guy who, the comedian, but this is largely for the Muslims as well, to also explain what are the boundaries, what are the limits, and also for people to understand, ah, that's why they don't like laughter. That's why. It's not like we're rigid folk. We like to also have a laugh and chill out as well, but there are their limits. In addition to that, what I want to mention, something which has become, na'uzubillah, the order of the day, and that is what people do is that they do pranks. Ya salam, people do these pranks. And the Prophet ﷺ, firstly, are they permissible? No. Abu Dawood 5004, Hadith Sahih, where it mentioned the Prophet ﷺ said, لا يحل لمسلم أن يروي عن مسلم. It is not permissible for any Muslim to frighten another Muslim. Ulama mentioned it's not just frightening other Muslims, any individual. The wording has just mentioned Muslims, but the scope also mentions or can contain everyone. So you can't go around scaring people. You can't go around, Ya Allah, I mean, I swear, someone showed me this thing and it, Ya Rabbi, you know, it doesn't present a good light for Islam. One geezer is dressed up in a thobe and he's got like a one of the Arab sort of like shawl thingies, you get me? And he's like throwing bags and watching people's reactions and recording them. And it's supposed to be done for fun, but that's not fun. Now, that's actually traumatizing people, because what people think, they've got a stereotype. Arab, this, bag. You can already know the conclusion, what's about what the people are thinking. They're literally running for their life. And people thought this was funny. But then there's another thing as well, when there's one brother, may Allah guide him and guide us as well. I'm talking about Muslims here. If it was a non-Muslim, then obviously, you know, I'm not saying that it's okay. It's not alright. I don't agree with the genre of pranks and these things. I think it's not right. But nevertheless, this was a Muslim couple of youths. They were going up and down escalators, hitting cream pies in people's faces. Cream pies, like cream, like, what are you doing? What are you doing? You know, and Ya Rab, all for likes, all for videos, all for just jokes. Unfortunately, there's no scope or no space for that in the deen. And then when we do joke, it shouldn't contain slander or backbiting or ridiculing about someone. That's something which is absolutely impermissible. The Prophet ﷺ, imagine this, right? Hadith number 2589 in Muslim. He mentioned to the Sahaba, what is ghiba? What is backbiting? He mentioned talking about your Muslim brother in a manner that he would dislike. And it was said to him, but what if my Muslim brother has that thing which I say? What I'm saying, he does do it or she does do it. What about that? The Prophet ﷺ said, if it is actually as you say, you've backbited him. And if it's not, then you've slandered him, which is even worse than backbiting, because you've completely fabricated something against the person. So what do I want to say in summary? The purpose of this video, like I said, is to give an explanation as to why Muslims get offended behind such things. At the end of the day, like I said, we're not Muslims, we don't like this sort of genre of jokes. We don't think that this is appropriate. We think, not just against Muslims, against anybody. Anybody, whether it's mocking the Holocaust, whether mocking, you know, feminist, whatever the case may be. We can differ on academic basis, but we can maintain our level of respect, but we don't think mocking and ridiculing is the way. And also as well, and to mention to those Muslims that, subhanAllah, who think that, okay, it's okay to do pranks and so on, fear Allah, it's not right. We need to fix up. We need to fix up, honestly. Just because what? You're going to get a like on Facebook. Now you're doing mashup stuff. Anyone who watches you and gets an idea that I can do a prank as well, you're going to get the guna and the sin for that. You know what I mean? Someone showed me this other video, one geezer, he's going around like dressed up like Rambo, like swinging a stick, frightening people in the middle of the street. He thinks it's a prank. Okay, the guy that you swung a stick near and you frightened him, he drove off, he didn't stop. How are you going to go to that person to ask for forgiveness and say, brother, I'm sorry, I startled you? You know, khair, like I said, we could, this can go on, and maybe this will be a platform for a Jumu'ah lecture for another time. But the point of mentioning is this. In summary or in conclusion, Islam is not against laughing. Islam is not against joking. Islam is not against having a laugh. Have a laugh, have a joke, but within its particular place. Be sensitive of the jokes. Know when to joke and how much to laugh. And don't take it excessively. This is what we've been encouraged by the Prophet ﷺ. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most likes in terms of how we should conduct ourselves, because the Prophet ﷺ's example is the best example for us to follow. In terms of, like I said to you, from the Salaf, you know, Sahaba, everyone had time to chill out, they catch some joke, they had some laughs, but it wasn't offensive, it wasn't ridiculing, wasn't defaming, it wasn't backbiting, it wasn't verbally assaulting people. And this was the difference between our laughs and the difference between their types of laugh. I also purchased this book, subhanAllah, about humorous anecdotes from the Salaf. And the book is literally about just catching joke from the Salaf, what the things which they said or did, and their truthful incidents, but they were kind of funny. You know, so subhanAllah, there is scope. But like I said, inshallah, you know, a detailed thing, inshallah, perhaps can follow another time. This was just a quick understanding of why, as Muslims, we don't agree with such a thing, and to shed light on the subject from an Islamic point of view, inshallah. I also want to reach out and say, if there's any other topic ideas you have, maybe you want to see something, hear something, mention in the comments below. Talk about this, discuss this, and inshallah we will try to discuss such topics. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us all safe, healthy. May Allah ta'ala keep us all, our hearts united. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the goodness and give you all goodness. Until next time, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.